Committee of the Whole. Turn this over to HR. Tom?
Good morning, Mr. Chairman. Today we're going to go through the employee engagement and retention survey. The end of last year. So that's not the same. I'm going to try and run through all the survey results and we'll have a discussion. Again, if you have specific questions. We had a 58% response rate from the 68 employees responding to the survey. So from four last 2 weeks in November, employees were offered two different opportunities to do it. One was direct email, the other was in the email. So I'm going to run through the quick synopsis of the survey. So employees were asked a number of engagement questions in four different categories, starting with job satisfaction and slash service. Job satisfaction, most employees find work meaningful and are satisfied with work-life balance. Fewer feel a sense of belonging and of additional growth opportunities. There are small groups that feel overworked and underpaid, with opportunities to improve and solve different services. 90% find their work meaningful. I also, for those of you that are visual versus numbers, I'm looking at both sides. So you can look at the bar chart, number one, or if you want to look at the specific percentage of response and number of responses. 80% are happy with the level of flexibility and balance. There is a desire to provide more growth opportunities. Digging deeper into this will help us understand what more is being asked. 75% are okay with their salary, but still 25% are. Morale is an issue in certain areas, but 18% of those say that is an issue. We asked open-ended questions, how the county could do better for job satisfaction. The answers vary between both the towns and the county's categories. Explain well.
Just a question on that. So most of those, other than the first one, are negative. Is there any correlation between the responses to the previous, all the previous questions, and who responded to these? I mean, if you look at this and you add it up, I mean, the numbers would say there's a pretty good portion that are not happy. But if those are the same people who said they weren't happy in previous questions, right?
Stress. Employees were asked about that. Most employees do not plan to leave their job or career in the next 2 years and would recommend working from home. There are factions that keep them safe, but if they have the tools to perform their job, a larger faction will be safe. So getting the specifics of those, 78% are happy with the job and 6% are ready to work. The question, they intend to leave this job for a similar job in the next 2 years, only 9% said they plan to leave in the next 2 years. If you agree with the job retention rate, two-thirds of the respondents would recommend working for the county. 75% feel they have all the tools to perform their job, but 11% say they have no opportunities. Or 18 employees disagree, say they do not feel safe in physical or emotional harm. What we don't know is specifically what that entails. Is that employees measure you'd ask us specifically about this one, how this compares to other sectors. And well, we didn't do that for all of these questions, so it's a little focus on internal comparisons and to ask specifically about this. The average burnout rate, according to a recent study posted in the Public Sector Human Resources Association, 52% of federal, state, and local government workers were burned out. We added 23% with neutral and neither agree to the 32 numbers. The neutral numbers for the what's that?
What did they do with the neutral numbers in the study you were citing? Yeah, so you couldn't add them in unless you knew. And then I understand that. And I do think normative data is really important, because otherwise it can look like we're doing well or look like we're doing poorly, and we might be looking at the wrong thing. So I appreciate you doing it for that, but I think it's important for other areas as well.
I think, just to piggyback on that, I think it matters what the question was and
Absolutely.
How they broke it down.
Yeah.
Maybe there wasn't an option to be neutral. Maybe there was an option to be above neutral or below neutral.
Right.
And
so
that,
if
yeah,
we don't
really
know that.
Unless you know what you're comparing
right.
to and what the question was,
exactly.
it's hard to.
I agree with you entirely.
Yeah.
The open-ended question for this category. Of what the county could be working on to be more supportive of employees really focuses on advanced leadership roles. There are some great opportunities here that we all know that we can do that. Some outreach efforts, ideas, as well as training that can focus on giving employees leadership and training for the future. Anecdotally, many responses pointed out that we will never be more than overall, we asked this open-ended question, what's the best thing about working for the county? So categories were people, co-workers, civic pride, flexibility, benefits, working in small towns slash the community location, the job itself, pay, leadership supervisors, job security. We asked what's the worst thing about high workload, lack of recognition, bureaucracy slash politics, nothing. The pay, leadership supervisor, public scrutiny, benefits. So then we move from the satisfaction question to focus. how we can include things to the benefits of the workforce. We ask employees about our current benefits and ask for suggestions from new employee customers. Starting off with the big one, 55% are satisfied with our health insurance, 25% are not. Items mentioned were high cost for families, high deductibles, and some things that are currently covered. Dental insurance, 26% are dissatisfied. Vision insurance, health savings accounts, 16% dissatisfied. Short-term, long-term disability, 10% and 12% respectively, dissatisfied. Life insurance. It's hard to figure out how you'd be satisfied with that unless you pass away, but flat rate of $40,000 for coverage has changed. So that would be something special. Paid sick leave, 82% are satisfied, 10% not. But when you get to vacation leave, positive and negative feelings shift by 17 points. 26% of the staff. Very little dissatisfaction with the deferred comp plan, but it's possible to do that. Pension plan. It's later when we get into some of the other questions, but people are asking if they want to see such a contribution. Overall, what would you improve about the benefits offered by Whitney County? Open-ended question. Routines of cheaper health care, coverage costs, better vacation accrual rates. County is doing a good job. Lower health care deductibles, better county contribution to retirement, better health care coverage. So then, we asked what other benefits employees see. We divided the request into three categories: financial, benefits, and flexibility. Each question was scored with a level of interest. So this is where we're going to use the percentage. All of the questions were graded, but not at all interested, extremely interested. You can see the weighted average is on the bottom right hand side. For the financial questions, when the answers were weighted, the top answers were retention bonus, retirement contribution from the employer, post-retirement health care savings plan. For the benefit category, increase in vacation accrual rates is the top, along with employer contributions to health benefits, and career-related training. Flexibility, everybody wants flexibility. Many were interested in the modified work week, ranging from creating summer hours, 4 10-hour weeks, 9 9-hour pay periods, or more opportunities for work. Of the potential benefits listed, which three would you most be interested in? Top four were increased vacation accruals, modified work weeks, and increased health contributions. Those that they're least interested in, so wrap up the top three in each of the new categories. You can see about the financial, the top three were retention bonus, retirement match contribution, post-retirement health care savings plan. The benefits most selected included increased vacation accrual rates, increased contribution to health benefits, and the flexibility, obviously, a large desire for overall, when you add average of all of the tops were, increased vacation accruals, modified work, increased healthcare contributions. So, what are we looking at? Our recommendation was that we put together a subcommittee to move forward with the retention efforts. Board had allocated a significant amount of money for retention efforts. So I think we need to sit down, talk about specifics of what we think the survey is giving us, determine what we need for retention efforts from long-term to short-term goals. What are easy, cheaper fixes versus more financial ones? Back in there, that county logo there at SLAG wasn't great to go high, but I guarantee if we have lots of issues at this point, people interested in that. So some different efforts that are high value, low cost, or low cost, high value.
Questions, go ahead.
All right, so one, morale being an issue, do you happen to know whether or not that's in one specific sector or if it's overall?
We were able to dial that down. We could see that some was overall, but we could see some that was department related.
All right, let's see.
I think the normative data is important because if the average low morale in any business is 10%, then what we're looking at is different than if the average is 0%, which I'm sure it's not. So I think without knowing the normative data, it's really hard to know if we're looking at the right thing. We might be doing better than we think in one area, and we might be doing worse than we think in another area.
When you're looking at the groups and you say, well, there's a small group that doesn't like this, there's a faction that doesn't like this, do you notice or through that when it's in a negative light, is that carry through on everything? So you just have four disgruntled employees that are voting negative on everything versus, you know, they found 8 good things but 2 bad things.
The first time reading through the survey results,
the other thing that struck me is there's a broad range of wishes that people had for benefits that, and it certainly could depend on your life stage, how many children you have, it could depend on all kinds of things. A lot of employers will offer a cafeteria of benefits. They'll contribute a certain amount, and then that individual is able to decide if they're going to spend it on life insurance or disability insurance or childcare, you know, on lots of different things. And I understand there's pros and cons to that, but I wonder if we've ever looked seriously at looking at where the employees had more flexibility. So, for example, an employee who already has health insurance through their spouse is actually not reaping nearly the benefits from the county as someone who needs that.
Linda?
On the question of feeling unsafe, so it looks like there was maybe 9% that answered the question, I feel safe at my workplace from physical, emotional harm. Well, disagreeing with that, 9%. But then later on, when with the open-ended questions, there was only one saying felt unsafe. Is that 1% or one? Okay, one respondent. Okay, thank you.
Kind of following on that same theme, and I kind of, as I looked through this and I kind of dwelled on that safety, and I, as anyone knows, I've been really adamant about what we do in this building is about ensuring worker safety. But when I really take a look at that, and I think, well, you know, we got sheriff's deputies out in patrol, and that's a high risk. But beyond that, we have assessors out county that have absolutely no protection when they're out doing that. And we have social workers that are going out. And I mean, there's really, when you really think about it, there's quite a few employees. It's not just the sheriff's department. That even land use sometimes ends up out in the country. And I don't know what to make of that, if that's some of that with the safety, or if it's actually they're saying they don't feel safe in this building, right? That building. Right? Yeah, I it's one that really, with the way the world is today, you got to think about protecting yourself somehow, and it just made me think about that differently. And then one other one was, what really surprised me is the question about childcare. And maybe it's because we have a more aged workforce. I don't believe really that. I mean, there's a lot of younger people in our departments now, and I thought childcare would be maybe higher on the ladder, but either we have enough child care in the county, which I don't believe, or it wasn't responded to the way I thought it would be.
I will comment that a third of the people didn't fill out the survey, and the busy moms might be overrepresented. In the group. Well, they might be.
Point well taken. Yeah.
One more thing on that. I mean, if you look at it, 55 people said that was the least important out of, you know, 380 people, and again, not everybody responded. So you've got a large portion that, you know, when you're looking at retirement, that, you know, childcare is certainly not your most important thing. It's probably your least important thing. You're happy they moved out and might be working by now.
That's why I sort of wondered about the cafeteria benefits, because yeah, the young parent would have different interests than the person within 10 years of retirement.
Yeah. The one thing I will say on the cafeteria plan, and it's been years since the county even broached the subject, but some employees, and this is not just our sector, but they have a little bit of a negative connotation on it, because when the cafeteria plans were originally brought out, they were brought out for cost containment. So when you start talking to union employees or employees in general about, you know, I want to get you on this cafeteria plan so we can contain costs, which is what everybody has in their mind from years ago, that's not something that a lot of people are interested in, because it reeks of, okay, you're going to trim my benefits back.
Right. So if it started out neutral, and then we looked at how much we want to increase benefits per year, then that's a different issue.
As long as it wasn't cost containment, I think you'd have open ears.
Yep. Thank you.
Anything else? Well, thank you. That was excellent.
So is the board direction to form a committee then? And if so, we'd like a couple of county board volunteers also.
Perfect.
personally, I think it's the only path forward. Unless it's not without county board involvement. But I think it takes a committee to kind of dig deeper into this, maybe figure out how to ask some different questions that get us farther in the weeds to making sure if we make a change, it is the right change.
Do we have any volunteers from the board?
Okay.
Linda? Okay, thank you. And
do you need a motion to
just a consensus?
Motion to consensus is good.
All right. I think we'll move forward. Thank you.
So Breck Biergen, our administration intern, will cover the next topic.
Yes, welcome.
More in depth. I document provides the scope and the shape of the program. The scope is where and who they collaborate with, the budget and the information. And the shape includes the goals and opportunities for the program, responsibilities covered in turn, and the kind of opportunities. Step two is creating the curriculum and end goals. This document provides questions to help figure out the goals for the interns, what are the needs in the department, and are there any weak spots in the department. Included are some examples of each department's core competencies that help figure out what you need to do. Month two is recruitment. Again, this is mainly HR, posting job descriptions, looking for applicants, Step four is creating the job description, and this is assigned to department heads because they have an idea of what kind of skills they want to have and who they're looking for. And once creating this, we want them to be very clear and specific so we can put them in the field. And this document asks job task duties and responsibility and a stated percent of time that takes up tasks in depth. And we want the department heads to write this up description like it's a business paper. And then steps 5 through 7 are self-assessment. Month 3 is partnering, and step 8 is connecting to partners. This is expected to take 2 weeks, and this is where it can get tricky for timeline and scheduling and reviewing, so make sure to try your best to stay on track and time. And then step 10 is sending out instructions internally and externally. So internal is where you can understand the department, and this checklist includes what actions are necessary for the employees, such as notifying the department employees that are in the role. Informing facilities for an ID badge, notifying ET for the uniform and system requirements, scheduling tasks and reminders for people and building check-ins, scheduling tours, decorating office space, and And note, if you want to make plans for them, please look at the And then the external checklist is 26 to 19. And all of this will be mentioned during the job offer phone call that will be sent to the email so that you can remember them. And then the checklist will congratulate them to say the start date. Start date where they go on the first day, and start at the door. The work hours, the dress code, what to expect for lunch, and what to bring to the island for and then sending out the questions. Month 4 is onboard, and this is when I think about the first week, the intern suddenly there and took the role. Steps 11 and 12 will be in HR, bringing up the communication, setting up the IT, and I'm Step 13 is the first check-in meeting, and this meeting will be with the intern or supervisor or the person of the interview. Over the duration of the internship, the intern and supervisor will have three check-in meetings, and this form will be received for check-in meetings to the interview. The first check-in meeting is to talk about the intern's expectations, training and resources, timeline, and ask questions. What are their goals for the internship? What are their interests in this department? Do they have any interests in other departments? Is there anything they really don't want to work on? And is there anything specific about them that they want? and testing issues. And then the last check in the room is similar to an exit interview, and it's meant to evaluate what they're earning on the new internship. Step 14 is tours, and earlier the department had been set up to provide information on for the HHS, ISCO, using policy, justice center, and other parts, and the teachers to interview students for how they feel about the environment to stay out of. Step 15 is shadowing. The intern will shadow for 2 weeks, depending on whether they just interested in what works. And this will be discussed in the first week. The department head will have this plan and communicate to the same people. The form that goes along with shadowing will answer major questions about shadowing and evaluate the answer in the intern's major questions about any of the things. Step 16 is non-task, and this will overlap with shadowing and take 4 weeks. The department head will come up with smaller tasks for the intern to accomplish. The form associated with non-task provides questions. And focus on department for competencies and what skills you want the intern to learn while being here. And note that it's important to come up with the school as many tasks for the intern to learn the skills that the student needs. 1-5 experience. This is the second month the intern is here. And step 19 is introducing the pilot project. So this is introduced halfway through the internship. Every intern is expected to complete and present a pilot project, but it is not required if the program has approved the funds. The project may vary in length, with shorter projects allowing interns to participate in more areas during the course of the internship. The supervisor of interns will propose and match the interests of the interns with the needs outlined in the proposals. The goal of a vital project is to provide the intern with a resume building experience that will help them in the future and for them to demonstrate practical benefits to open a technical strategy, including creative thinking and the abilities to work. Communication skills and presenting information effectively. Questions are then asked with any questions for the project. So for example, this is my current project. There is a need for an internship program, not necessarily a key spot in the department. So this is basically my project. I conducted research, created interesting paperwork, communicated with this was a bigger project which took many months to create and size the project's convening. Interns will present to the planning board and it's necessary just to do the project. And then step 20 is working on the final project. This will take roughly 7 weeks and the rest of the internship is really focusing on the final project. But they can still finish smaller tasks for themselves. And then month 6 is last month. Interns mainly working with the and then step 22 is presenting the final project. And step 24 is the final review in March. The department head should be in the final month with employees and departments. Communicate and connect with people. The intern is working with all summer. It's going to break a send off and a final meeting in the interim. So everything that I created can be found in the common drive under internship program. It has all the forms and documents needed for tasks and it has the timeline. There is a folder called Department Interns that just has a simple markup of job descriptions, but keep in mind it's not going to be every department. So, conclusion, internship program implemented for Bibb County will help the planning process and create better outcomes, not just for the intern, but everyone involved. And this is just here to help guide the process of an internship for department heads or supervisors. That is a lot of information. Thank you for listening.
Do we have any questions? Thank you very much. You put a lot of work into this. Very appreciated. Very nice. Anyone?
Just a comment. To be on an internship, designing an internship program, that's a challenge in itself. Yeah. But appreciate the work you've done on this. We got to figure out ways to recruit people. I think internships is a great way to recruit people. So I am really thankful we got the framework to work with, and thanks for all your work on it.
Briggs, were you the supervisor? All right, well done, Briggs, from going from your internship to an employee and to now helping to put together the internship program. So well done, both of you.
Your hesitation, Briggs, almost made me think that she was managing you.
No. All right. Anything else? Well, thank you for doing that. Appreciate it. Our HHS meeting will be in 15 minutes.